Today, I'm going to show you how to make a Polaroid frame picture in Photoshop. Hey guys, and welcome to Phlearn. My name is Aaron Nace, and you can find me on Phlearn.com, where we make learning Photoshop and photography the most fun you've ever had in your life. Today we're doing something really cool. We're gonna take a normal snapshot and we're gonna make it look like it was taken in as a Polaroid. And I know you're probably saying this is totally silly and weird, but the days of actually using a Polaroid camera are gone. You can't buy Polaroid film anymore, and sometimes you still want that like Polaroid type of look. So if you are one of those people who want that look and all you have is digital files, we're gonna show you how to do everything in Photoshop. All right, so to achieve this effect, you're gonna need two things. The first is a picture of an actual Polaroid, and the second is your photo. So where do you get a picture of a Polaroid? That's a great question. Well, DeviantArt is a really great place to find things like stock images. So I did a stock image search, and I found this picture of a Polaroid, and it's by Lured to Stock. And basically, we'll link to this in a comment down below in the description so you guys can actually get to this. But it's really easy to find pictures of Polaroids. You can find them here on stock websites and things like that. But this is what we're gonna be using for today's episode. All right, so let's jump into Photoshop and see how we do this effect. So we've got two images here. We've got our lovely couple here on vacation, and we've got our Polaroid image. So first thing I need to do is I need to get them together. So we're gonna use the Move tool here. So we're gonna click on the Move tool, and I'm gonna hold down Shift and click and drag from one image to another. And that just puts them on the same document. You can see we have two layers now, the background and our couple. All right, let's go ahead and close this image out. This is a stock image from Fotolia. I don't know these people in the photo. Probably gonna be using pictures of people you actually know. All right, let's hit F for full screen here so we can see what we're doing. Okay, now I'm gonna make this invisible for now because I don't need it just yet. What we wanna do is I wanna make a selection on my background, basically of the space where the people are going to be in. So what we're gonna do, let's just zoom in a little bit. I'm gonna hit W for my magic wand, or you can just go right up here. And basically I wanna click right here in the center of my dark area. Now, if you're not selecting enough, just bring your tolerance up a little bit. So let's try a tolerance of 32. Let's go up to 40. There we go. And you can see pretty much it's extending all the way to the very edge of the selection. So we have that as a selection. Now we can load that as a layer mask for the actual portrait. So let's make our portrait visible here. And when you have a selection, all you have to do to make a layer mask is click on your layer mask button, which is right down here. So clicking on your layer mask button, that's a lot of the work that's done for you. Now, there's one really cool thing I wanna show you guys, and that has to do with linking layers to their layer masks. So at default right now, if I were to move this image around, you can see it's moving, but it's not staying within the frame of the Polaroid. That's because the layer and the layer mask are linked together. Now you can click on this chain link between the two, and that's going to unlink them. Now you can move the layer and the layer mask independently. So for instance, if I want to move my layer, I can do that and the mask is going to stay in the same exact place. I could move the mask too by clicking on the mask and moving that around, but in this case, this would just not give me what I wanted. So we're going to move the layer around. You can even transform it. So I'm going to hit Command T. Let's just zoom out and maybe just stretch that down a little bit so we can actually include a little bit more. There we go. Beautiful. Okay, and then when you're done, you're gonna wanna hit on this little chain link again. So our people are in place. Let's go ahead and grab an adjustment layer. I'm gonna go down to hue/saturation. Okay, now I wanna give it that kind of like Polaroid type look. So I'm actually gonna click on this colorize button, and we're gonna give it like a nice sepia tone. There we go, and bring up our saturation. There we go, that looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and close that down. So you'll notice that this layer, this adjustment layer, it affects everything. It's affecting the picture of the people as well as the background, the Polaroid itself. We don't want that. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna click on this, we're gonna right click, and I'm gonna go to create a clipping mask. And what that's gonna do is it's going to make this layer only affect the layer that's under it. So you can see now it's only affecting the picture. Okay, now it's too strong an effect, so we're just gonna go to our opacity, and I'm gonna lower that down quite a bit. There we go. So you can see it still has that effect. It's just not so visible, not so visible. All right, let's create a new layer. I'm gonna clip that to this layer. I'm gonna clip that to our Polaroid as well. And now I'm just gonna grab a brush tool and with like a super large soft edge brush, I'm just gonna paint some white like in the top left corner. And this will make it look like it's, you know, was actually part of the, you know, it's a little bit of flare or whatever you have from like, you know, Polaroids don't, they're not perfect every time. So something like that, just to make it look a little bit more like it's actually part of the effect. All right, we're almost there. Let's see. The next thing I wanna do, we're gonna zoom in here, and I just wanna take care of this border, because you can see the border between our people and the edge, it's pretty good. I just wanna make it fuzzy, just a little bit more fuzzy to make it more realistic. So we're gonna click on our layer mask. We're gonna go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. And we're just gonna give this a tiny Gaussian Blur. There we go. And you can even see it makes it look like it's kind of set in there, like a little bit of a shadow, which is cool. So there's the before and the after with that. Now, I'm a perfectionist. You guys don't have to follow all these steps, but this is what I would do to make it actually look real. So everything looks good. We just need to add some text under the Polaroid to make it look authentic. So we're gonna create a new layer here. And basically, I'm just gonna grab my brush tool and we're gonna write something like, we like this song. How romantic. the only problem is that this doesn't really look real. It looks like it was actually done in Photoshop. So I'm gonna show you a really neat trick to make it look like it's actually taking some of the texture from the background and applying it to the text. So what we're gonna do is double click here on our layer, double click, and we're looking for layer style. And then down here at the bottom, you're gonna see it's gonna say blend if. And this will allow you to blend it in where the underlying layers are either lighter or darker. Now, that's a little bit confusing. I'll just show you how it works and that makes it a lot more simple. So I'm gonna hold Alt or Option, and here where I see my underlying layer, I'm just gonna click from the left to the right, and we're just gonna move this guy just a little bit over. And basically what you're gonna see is it's going to take the texture of the underlying layer and apply it over top of here. It's basically making this text not visible where the underlying layer is lighter, and that kind of comes across as texture, which is exactly what we want. So that's it, we're done. So there you can see, let's just show you, there's the before, totally looks like Photoshop, and the after, now it looks like it's actually on the Polaroid, like a boss. Let's go ahead and take a look at our before and the after. Here's our stock image of a Polaroid, which you can get on a variety of websites, and here's our after, getting our couple in here and some text on the bottom for a completed effect that would look totally cool on a blog. All right, guys, that's the end of today's episode. Thank you so much for hanging out with me and learning some Photoshop. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. And if you did, subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's super simple because we'll just put a big button on the screen right now and you can click on that and get free Photoshop and photography tutorials every single week from Phlearn. And if you have an idea about today's episode or something you'd like to see in general, just leave us a comment right down below. That's how we get the ideas for these episodes so we can keep delivering great tutorials to you just till the end of time. I'm just gonna have a long white beard in many years and continue delivering these tutorials. So if you keep watching them, I'll keep making them. Thanks again, guys. I'll Phlearn you later. Bye, everyone. They'll call me Whitebeard. Whitebeard the Magnificent, the Photoshop Master. I have many powers and all of them exist in Photoshop. So they are completely useless to the real world.